Fox News alert and U.S. officials, intelligence officials, are reportedly finding that North Korea already has produced a miniaturized nuclear warhead.
The new analysis by the U.S. Defense Intelligence Agency is estimating North Korea now has nuclear weapons in its arsenal.
North Korea is vowing revenge, condemning that latest round of United Nations sanctions, warning that it's going to make the U.S. pay dearly, which means that President Trump is waking up this morning with a serious foreign policy showdown on his hands.
They will be met with fire, fury, and frankly, power, the likes of which this world has never seen before.
The president in Bedminster holding an hour-long phone call with his Secretary of State overseas in Asia as Kim Jong-un's rogue regime warns its nuclear weapons and ballistic missiles are not on the negotiating table. From a state TV broadcaster, this apparent threat. There's no bigger mistake than the U.S. thinking it's safe because it's across an ocean.
North Korea lashing out over new U.N. sanctions. Overnight, the Kim Jong-un regime vowed to take physical action and retaliate, quote, thousands of times over. The threat comes after U.S. spy agencies spotted the country loading anti-ship cruise missiles onto a patrol boat.
We start off this hour bringing in from the National Interest Director of Defense Studies, Harry Kazianis, who's with us along with the former CIA military analyst Tara Mueller. So, all right, guys, good to see both of you. I'm going to start, Harry, with you on this. And it's the newest, as I said, development on top of a number of other developments that lead us to believe this week that tensions have spiked, right, with North Korea. But this is a kind of, a, I guess, a technological development. What do you make of it?
Well, Connell, I think today at 12:22, when the Washington Post story broke, we can definitively declare North Korea a nuclear power. Hmm. Not only a nuclear power, but a power that can hit the United States with an intercontinental ballistic missile. The report also says that North Korea not only has 12 to 20 nuclear weapons, like we've been saying for quite a long time now, but 60 nuclear weapons. So these are all game-changing revelations that we have to be concerned about. The biggest takeaway, we are out of time.
And President Trump also weighed in on North Korea this morning from his golf club in New Jersey. The president took to Twitter, writing, quote, after many years of failure, countries are coming together to finally address the dangers posed by North Korea. We must be tough and decisive. A CBS News poll out this morning shows most Americans are worried that North Korea's nuclear weapons program could lead to war. 72% say they are uneasy about a possible conflict.
North Korea may now be capable of making missile-ready nuclear weapons. According to the assessment, that means they may now be able to launch a nuclear weapon capable of reaching the United States.
It's a key component in Pyongyang's path to become a full-fledged nuclear power.
CBS News senior national security analyst Fran Townsend joins us now by phone. Fran, can you explain exactly what this technology means as far as North Korea's growth as a nuclear power?
Sure. Thanks for having me. Look, we've seen a steady development of the missile program. There's been at least 12 launches in the last year. And so we know that North Korea's been working on their missile program. The next critical piece is the miniaturization of a warhead so that it fits on top of the missile. That's what we understand this assessment says, that they have now hit that milestone.
And as the hard facts come in, let's go to senior foreign affairs correspondent Greg Palcott with more. Greg?
Harris, it is an alarming report coming from the Washington Post, and at least one of my valued sources on the subject of North Korea thinks that it is true. Let's go through the report very quickly. Washington Post quoting defense intelligence officials saying that North Korea is now capable of producing nuclear weapons for ballistic missile delivery. That is a warhead small enough to put on one of the many missiles that they have been testing. Now, North Korea, if you remember, has been claiming exactly that. Last year, in fact, they said they tested one such bomb, and they even showed a picture, which we weren't sure was accurate or not, showing Kim Jong-un with a miniaturized bomb. Again, we weren't sure that was true, but if this report is true, it means that these ICBMs, for example, two of them that we've seen launched last month, that we've been saying was capable of hitting the United States could have something lethal on top. Again, Harris, let me go back to my source. His name is Mark Fitzpatrick. He's with the International Institute of Strategic Studies, and I just got off the phone with him discussing this with him. He's based in Washington, D.C. He says basically this is what analysts have been saying for a while now, that North Korea is capable of doing this, that they're very competent technological people. They've been working on this for 30 years, but governments have been a little bit more reticent to say they are at this crucial threshold. I think my own analysis, Harris, is that today, early this morning, U.S. time, Japan came out with a report citing their own officials saying that they believed that North Korea was capable of miniaturizing these nuclear warheads. Perhaps that is what pushed some people in Washington to talk to the Washington Post about this and say this. One final note on this, Harris, is that it also in that report it says that there are 60 warheads now possibly in the arsenal of North Korea. Fitzpatrick and others think that's a little bit high. It's maybe more like 20 or 30. But frankly, that's quibbling with numbers at this point, Harris.
Yeah, you know, you're mentioning Japan and our military, our officials rather wanting to get out ahead of the story, if you will. Japan would want to put that information out, their own capability, because remember the latest launch by North Korea came within 230 miles of their coastline. Of course, they'd want to get the word out that we're going to be able to defend ourselves. What's being done right now to prevent this from encroaching any farther?
Yeah, Harris, as we've been reporting today, Secretary of State Tillerson has been very active trying to gather support in the region of Southeast Asia for the UN Security Council sanctions that were passed over this weekend, basically that could cut maybe $1 billion out of annual revenue coming into North Korea that could fuel those programs. Today, he was in Thailand, also in Malaysia, major trading partners with North Korea, trying to convince them to toe the line on this. And we have been hearing from North Korea, too. Their state media has been pumping out the usual rhetoric we have been hearing from the regime of Kim Jong-un, saying something like that they are getting ready for a savage physical attack on the United States in the wake of these sanctions, which were basically written by the United States, specifically claiming that they did have the capability of hitting the mainland of the United States. And with this latest information, all of that has a little bit more resonance, Harris.
Greg, before I let you go, I want to lean in a little bit on your own expertise, because you have been to North Korea. You have been following the chain, if you will, of what's happening behind that curtain that we cannot see. Enhance your reporting, if you can, with your own experience.
Well, in fact, talking to the people on the ground there, as we have in our visits to Pyongyang and the officials, their line is that we have it. We have the weaponry. We have the missiles. We are able to use them, and there's no taking them away from us. I had a lengthy conversation with one official, and he said that it was just basically a joke to think that we would give that up.
We're out of time to stop North Korea from getting a nuclear weapon, and that's a sad day.
Crazy when you think about it. That's some statement. By the way, you think with that, that if we're declaring within the last hour that North Korea is officially a nuclear power, that the stock market would be way down. Not to overly focus on that, but it's kind of what we do here to some extent. It's off the highs, but we're still up 18 right in the Dow at 22,136. So we keep setting these record highs on Wall Street no matter what happens, which I think is kind of interesting, although it's off the subject here a little bit. Tara, how important do you think this development is? This Washington Post report, as Harry points out, that the he thinks it's official now. North Korea is a nuclear power. How would you put it?
I think it's really important. If true, it's a significant development. It also sort of begs the question, though, they may have the miniaturized device, but we don't know if they have the capability to actually put that and marry it with an intercontinental ballistic missile. We've also seen their missile launches going up dramatically since the Trump administration has come into office. So now you're seeing not just a quantity increase in missile tests, but you're seeing a significant, what you'd say, more of like a quality increase as well, because now it seems they might have the capability to have nuclear material, a nuclear explosive device that can be put on a missile, which is obviously a major concern for the United States. Mm-hmm. Having said that, I think we're still in the same place, a bad place option-wise, where we were without this new information. What are the options we have here? We're trying to chokehold them with more sanctions. We'll see if China and Russia comply with the sanctions that were just passed by the UN in terms of enforcement. And if the sanctions don't modify the behavior, we're going to need to get the North Koreans to the table, and we're going to need to start to do some high-level, six-party-style talks, diplomacy, and we're going to need to probably start thinking outside the box here and see if any sort of deal or negotiation strategy can be made. The North Koreans right now don't seem willing to sit down.
No.
That is a very big problem. Sanctions are important. We need to punish with sanctions, but they're not alone going to change North Korean behavior.
No, I hear you. So say they do work. I mean, say that China, and your point's well taken, we don't know whether they will or not, but say China goes along, Russia goes along, as they voted that they said they would at the United Nations, Harry. But to Tara's point, then we tried diplomacy, and they don't want to sit down and talk. I mean, then where are you? Because to talk to most experts on this area, most people say that, you know, just a preemptive military strike, it doesn't make a lot of sense, because what if this guy in Kim Jong-un is really backed into a corner then, and he actually uses this technology that he reportedly has?
Right. Well, there's all the bombs in the world aren't going to solve the North Korean problem, because let's face the facts here. If North Korea does have 60 nuclear weapons, you would need a massive military strike to take out all 60 of these weapons. And the North Koreans are very good at hiding things in caves, bunkers.
Exactly. Well, if you just miss one, it's a terrible hypothetical, right, Harry, because you miss one and forget about it.
Exactly. You're going to see Seoul or Tokyo, basically millions of people die.
Thank you for watching Right Wing. Your support really does mean the world to me. I hope you have an amazing rest of the day, and I will see you tomorrow.
Report, it says that there are 60 warheads now possibly in the arsenal of North Korea. Fitzpatrick and others think that's a little bit high. It's maybe more like 20 or 30, but frankly, that's quibbling with numbers at this point, Harris.
Yeah, you know, you're mentioning Japan and our military, our officials rather wanting to get out ahead of the story, if you will. Japan would want to put that information out, their own capability, because remember, the latest launch by North Korea came within 230 miles of their coastline. Of course, they'd want to get the word out that we're going to be able to defend ourselves. What's being done right now to prevent this from encroaching any farther?
Yeah, Harris, as we've been reporting today, Secretary of State Tillerson has been very active trying to gather support in the region of Southeast Asia for the UN Security Council sanctions that were passed over this weekend, basically that could cut maybe $1 billion out of annual revenue coming into North Korea that could fuel those programs. Today, he was in Thailand, also in Malaysia, major trading partners with North Korea, trying to convince them to toe the line on this. And we have been hearing from North Korea, too. Their state media has been pumping out the usual rhetoric we have been hearing from the regime of Kim Jong-un, saying something like that they are getting ready for a savage physical.
According to the assessment, that means they may now be able to launch a nuclear weapon capable of reaching the United States.
It's a key component in Pyongyang's path to become a full-fledged nuclear power.
CBS News senior national security analyst Fran Townsend joins us now by phone. Fran, can you explain exactly what this technology means as far as North Korea's growth as a nuclear power?
Sure. Nat, thanks for having me. Look, we've seen a steady development of the missile program. There's been at least 12 launches in the last year. And so we know that North Korea's been working on their missile program. The next critical piece is the miniaturization of a warhead so that it fits on top of the missile. That's what we understand this assessment says, that they have now hit that milestone.
And as the hard facts come in, let's go to senior foreign affairs correspondent Greg Palcott with more. Greg?
Harris, it is an alarming report coming from the Washington Post, and at least one of my valued sources on the subject of North Korea thinks that it is true. Let's go through the report very quickly. Washington Post quoting defense intelligence officials saying that North Korea is now capable of producing nuclear weapons for ballistic missile delivery. That is a warhead small enough to put on one of the many missiles that they have been testing. Now, North Korea, if you remember, has been claiming exactly
the national interest director of defense studies, Harry Kazianis, who's with us along with the former CIA military analyst Tara Mueller. So, all right, guys, good to see both of you. I'm going to start, Harry, with you on this. And it's the newest, as I said, development on top of a number of other developments that lead us to believe this week that tensions have spiked, right, with North Korea. But this is a kind of, a, I guess, a technological development. What do you make of it?
Well, Connell, I think today at 12:22, when the Washington Post story broke, we can definitively declare North Korea a nuclear power. Hmm. Not only a nuclear power, but a power that can hit the United States with an intercontinental ballistic missile. The report also says that North Korea not only has 12 to 20 nuclear weapons, like we've been saying for quite a long time now, but 60 nuclear weapons. So these are all game-changing revelations that we have to be concerned about. The biggest takeaway, we are out of time.
And President Trump also weighed in on North Korea this morning from his golf club in New Jersey. The president took to Twitter, writing, quote, "After many years of failure, countries are coming together to finally address the dangers posed by North Korea. We must be tough and decisive." A CBS News poll out this morning shows most Americans are worried that North Korea's nuclear weapons program could lead to war. 72% say they are uneasy about a possible conflict.
North Korea may now be capable of making missile-ready nuclear weapons.
That last year, in fact, they said they tested one such bomb. And they even showed a picture, which we weren't sure was accurate or not, showing Kim Jong-un with a miniaturized bomb. Again, we weren't sure that was true, but if this report is true, it means that these ICBMs, for example, two of them that we've seen launched last month, that we've been saying was capable of hitting the United States, could have something lethal on top. Again, Harris, let me go back to my source. His name is Mark Fitzpatrick. He's with the International Institute of Strategic Studies, and I just got off the phone with him discussing this with him. He's based in Washington, D.C. He says basically this is what analysts have been saying for a while now, that North Korea is capable of doing this, that they're very competent technological people. They've been working on this for 30 years, but governments have been a little bit more reticent to say they are at this crucial threshold. I think my own analysis, Harris, is that today, early this morning, U.S. time, Japan came out with a report citing their own officials saying that they believed that North Korea was capable of miniaturizing these nuclear warheads. Perhaps that is what pushed some people in Washington to talk to the Washington Post about this and say this. One final note on this, Harris, is that it also in that
a Fox News alert and U.S. officials, intelligence officials, are reportedly finding that North Korea already has produced a miniaturized nuclear warhead.
The new analysis by the U.S. Defense Intelligence Agency is estimating North Korea now has nuclear weapons in its arsenal.
North Korea is vowing revenge, condemning that latest round of United Nations sanctions, warning that it's going to make the U.S. pay dearly, which means that President Trump is waking up this morning with a serious foreign policy showdown on his hands.
They will be met with fire, fury, and frankly, power, the likes of which this world has never seen before.
The president in Bedminster holding an hour-long phone call with his Secretary of State overseas in Asia as Kim Jong-un's rogue regime warns its nuclear weapons and ballistic missiles are not on the negotiating table. From a state TV broadcaster, this apparent threat. There's no bigger mistake than the U.S. thinking it's safe because it's across an ocean.
North Korea lashing out over new U.N. sanctions. Overnight, the Kim Jong-un regime vowed to take physical action and retaliate, quote, thousands of times over. The threat comes after U.S. spy agencies spotted the country loading anti-ship cruise missiles onto a patrol boat.
We start off this hour bringing in from the National